product, the ICT website that we're going to be using, and I logged in. I'm going to click on Manage Resources. And I'm going to click a short name, or type a short name field for this. The first one I'm going to do is the CSV file that I exported. Resources started, and I'm going to choose file. This time, I'm going to go ahead and choose the WFEZ DWC2.zip file. I know that there is a CSV file within the zip file, and I also know this is a rather large file, so I definitely want to load it with the zip. Now, I see it's taking a little bit longer. You can see the percentage of showing in the lower left corner. How big is this data set, John?
Megabytes.
Okay. 189,000 records. And I had saved it as UTF-8, so it did come in that way. Preview the data. You can check it out and my date last month doesn't look great, so I must have done something with my export. Dates are one of the hardest things to get out of your system in the right format. See if I got collection data right. So again, after seeing this, I would go back and modify my data set, export it again, trying to get the correct formats. Okay, that's the end of this part.
Point out the information, the summary information about having that project.
Right here. So after you come back to your manage resource screen, you see the file name, you see how many megabytes the file size was, your number of records, and how many columns of data. So that's your number of fields. Occasionally, if you do have that issue with extra row numbers, when you go to publish, it'll tell you how many records may not have met the correct number of columns that you uploaded. And so that's another indicator that you would know that something was off with your data. And we could come back in here and edit if we needed to. There is another option for connecting to a database source directly, and you can write SQL statements in here and connect to a database. I'm not sure, was there anybody in here that would do that? Connect to MySQL or Oracle or a Microsoft SQL Server? Okay. If anybody decides they want to see that tomorrow, just let me know. I've got several examples from people that we host that I could show. Okay, Kyle suggested that I show you an export from Google Refine to bring that in. So what I'll do is I know that WSEZ, actually I don't want to bring that one in, it's too many. Bring the UTEP one in, and that we fixed from the other day. So this one, I know we worked on it the other day, and it's got institution code, we've got an occurrence ID, a collection code. I showed you this yesterday where you can edit cells and transform them with the common transform to date. So I simply fixed that one. We have some of the extra fields that I had added. And we're going to export. Choose comma separated value. And I'm going to show you what happens if you upload a file that has a different name. So this one is utep-csv.csv. When I open that one and add it, back the correct number of records for me. There were no issues there. And when I preview the date column, it's in the correct format. It recognized that it was UTF-8. So I'll click save. And now it shows me that I have two files here. So I definitely don't want to keep both files, because if I were to publish with both files, it would duplicate my record now. Not duplicate it exactly, but that came together. So I'm going to go back into the first one. So I'm going to pull up the exercise from yesterday, and I'm going to do the reconcile process. So I click names, reconcile, start reconciling. Click add standard service. I paste in the service name. Tells you on the left side what happened, and it didn't match on 7 of them. See the names, and they're in blue now. Occasionally, you might see one that has more than one. This one did not. But you can see these had a percentage of them. So it either matched exactly, or it was pretty darn close in this case. So they were 99% matched. If you had more in there, you'd find some that didn't match. And then you would know those needed to be researched. And perhaps those weren't valid scientific names. So now I'm going to add a column based on this column. And we're going to add the ID field. Thank you. got the name bank ID, and we've got the extracted name, and that's where this is. You can see the difference. Because this was not 100% match on these two, you have to accept them before they would have shown up in this next column. So there were a couple of decisions to be made on names. And then as part of the reconciling process, there is an option to match each cell to its best candidate. And so that's how you go through accepting them. But that's usually not something you want to do without actual review of your names. And then, like we did yesterday in the other exercise, I'm going to clear the reconciliation data from this column so that we can see what our original submission was. So if you guys were to try that exercise now, it will work. Any questions? Yes.
What options or services exist to be able to do that?
There are, within this blog post, Rob Page has developed a few other services that he lists. There is one that uses the Encyclopedia of Life, one that uses NCBI, so he's got links to all of their sites, one for worms, one for GDIF, Global Names Index. You can see what information is available to be called back. So when